the very proud principal of Chopticon High School, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to the Class of 2021 commencement ceremony. Please rise for the Class of 2021 and remain standing for the pledge to the flag. Class of 2021 and the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated.
It is my distinct honor to introduce to you some of our very special guests. Dr. Scott Smith, Superintendent of St. Mary's County Public Schools. Ms. Shelley McDaniel, 12th grade administrator. Ms. Chris White, college and career advisor. Ms. Ashley Gallo, sponsor of the Student Government Association. Ms. Rebecca Hooven, English teacher and yearbook supervisor. And Ms. Jill Hayden, Class of 2021 salutatorian. And last but not least, Mr. Matthew Rodriguez, Class of 2021 class sponsor. And now I want to speak directly to the graduates. Class of 2021, I know this is not how you envision your graduation to look or how your senior year to go. For me too, this is not how I expected my first year as your principal to go. Yet here we are, just a few moments away from graduating. You didn't come here today to hear me speak, so I want to make my remarks brief, 4.5 minutes to be exact. I timed it. And instead of a traditional speech, what I want to share with you today are two important things that we have learned from you. Two important life lessons that you have taught us and that I hope you will continue to share as you move past the very proud halls of Chopticon High School. Number one, you have shown us how to confront real struggles. Most people do everything they can to avoid struggling, whether it's physical struggle, mental, emotional, or academic struggle. Most people avoid struggling at all costs. While these folks are trying to make their lives easier, they effectively do just the opposite. They shield themselves from meaningful, difficult learning experiences. You graduating class of 2021 are the opposite of these people. You were confronted with a reality where it would have been understandable to view yourself as a victim, to blame your environment, and to expect less of yourself. But instead, you worked harder and you rose to the challenges that life threw at you. So when people tell me how sorry they are for you, I can't help but to think, yes, I'm sorry for what you had to deal with, but I am so incredibly proud of you for how you dealt with it. Proud that you chose to persevere, proud of your character, proud of your ability to turn adversity into a growth opportunity, and proud of your choice to confront your adversity rather than avoid it. You, graduating class of 2021, by virtue of sitting before us here today, have shown us that you are not broken, you are resilient, and we are proud of you beyond measure for making it here. Number two, you have reminded us of the profound importance of human connection. You have taught us on a new level the value of people connecting with each other socially and emotionally. Unfortunately, we have also seen the profound negative consequences when these connections are lost. In the last decade, and especially in this last year of COVID, mental health concerns, anxiety, depression, and suicide have all been increasing to unprecedented levels. Why? It is within this context and with this profoundly important question that you step into the working world and face the challenges of adulthood. But I'm not worried for you, because it is you who showed us that these are not problems to be solved with better content knowledge, better technical skills, or anything that you learn from a book or a PowerPoint. You have shown us that these are problems to be solved with human connection, authentic relationships, and compassion. You have reminded us of the literal life-saving implications of coming together as a community or simply reaching out to a friend. Because of this, I am confident that it is your generation, with you leading the way, that will be the ones to make real human connections that change our world for the better. Not because of the content and skills that we have taught you, but because of the value of human connection that you have taught us. In closing, I want to thank you, Chopticon Braves. Thank you for showing us that in life we don't always have choices in the struggles we face, but we do have a choice in how we face them. Thank you for showing us that the most important problems in our lives will not be solved with social media, the latest technology, or any discrete skills or content, but by human connection and compassion. Finally, thank you for teaching us all these lessons just by being you, exactly who you are. Thank you and congratulations. Now, please welcome to the stage our class of 2021 salutatorian, Ms. Jill Hayden.
Class of 2021, our 4 years at Chopticon have been unlike any other class. We have been together for a long time now, and we have all grown and changed in many different ways. Most of us first met at Margaret Brent, where the highlight of our school day was playing speedball in Ms. Sapp's class. Now, 6 years later, graduating high school, where we are ready to go our separate ways and start our own journey. Freshman year, we were all starting over, going to a new school as the little kids again, and not knowing our way around. We endured our first high school tryouts with nervousness and anxiety, not knowing whether or not we were going to make the team. We all struggled to find our place, foster old and new friendships, and identify our purpose. In our sophomore year, we were all eager to get our driver's licenses and gain greater freedoms. We were starting to think about our futures. Junior year, we were the upperclassmen, the bigger kids. We were role models for the younger ones. We started taking advantage of Tech Center, dual enrollment, and AP classes. We widened our college searches and started narrowing down on our interests for our future career paths. Then the coronavirus hit. We were sent home for the rest of the school year to continue virtually. We continued to persevere as a class, taking on this new style of learning. Through these experiences, we have grown to overcome and face any challenge ahead of us. Who would have thought that we would have spent our senior year going to school for only 30 in-person days? Social distancing and wearing masks at school made us learn to work together in unique ways. We, along with the teachers, navigated through Google Meets, breakout rooms, and Schoology. Although this year was not how we have ideally wanted our senior year to go, we have learned a lot from this experience. We have all learned to be more appreciative and never take the little things for granted. I'm sure we are all appreciative of the traditions we are able to carry on, such as barn painting and the senior picnic, along with the adjustments that were made by coaches and athletes to make high school sports possible. I would like to thank all of the teachers for making sure online learning went as smoothly as possible. I know this was not an easy task. A few memories I will not forget at Chopticon are Mrs. Summers kissing a cow and Perner kissing a pig. I will cherish the time spent playing sports, being involved in clubs, and enjoying time with my friends in high school. The highlight of these years in high school have been celebrating Spirit Week and pep rallies, always decking out for Braves Day and trying to scream the loudest to win the Spirit Stick. Our class always loved watching football games, cheering in Chop Nation, and always competing with Leonardtown, knowing they would all wear camo every time we played them. We will all miss being greeted by Mr. Mike, always seeing him cheerful in the mornings. And we will never forget seeing Miss Courtney in the halls and always being called beautiful and handsome. All of the athletes will miss spending time with our teammates who became family, breaking records, and having Sapp and Wes visiting our practices. We were the young juniors who beat the seniors in Powder Puff and who would have gone on to beat the juniors if we would have had a Powder Puff game this year. Some special activities we got to enjoy, thanks to the staff, was petting dogs for Mental Health Day and the in-school basketball games against the teachers, all while being with our friends every day. I will even miss trying to cram for AP tests, the smell of cow manure on a hot day, Gallo blaring her music throughout the halls, the days that felt as if we had no air conditioning, and the random fire alarms we would have that resulted in the fire department coming to school on multiple occasions. As we move on to adults post-graduation, these small things that we thought were a burden will become the special memories we fondly recall and miss the most. It's hard to believe that 4 short years ago, I was the little freshman chasing after the bus at least 3 days of every week. These years have gone by so fast, and we have all grown and changed so much. Peace out, class of 2021. We all had a good time together, and I know you all have a bright future ahead of you. Now please welcome our Superintendent of Schools, Dr. J. Scott Smith.
It's better. Class of 2021, I can see you smiling eyes there. Give me a smile, eye crinkles in the corners. Yeah? Okay. Class of 2021, you will enter a world like no other, one that hopefully won't take for granted how special it is to gather, to see each other's smiles, to hug, and to hold loved ones. I'd like to take a moment just to thank each of you for getting us here. Graduates, thank you for getting us here. Teachers, counselors, support staff, administrators, thank you for getting us here. and most importantly, everybody else gathered in the audience, the parents, the grandparents, the aunts, the uncles, the family friends, thank you for all stepping up, filling the gaps as we worked each day to simply get through. And sometimes that was all we were able to do. Robert Frost wrote, "The best way out is through." And we find ourselves here mere moments away from you walking across the stage and getting out. And it's because everybody in here has persevered. So to the class of 2021, the masked class, the class undaunted, the class that has marked and made history, I say congratulations and job well done. May all your days that follow be filled with family and friends, smiling and holding a hug a bit tighter and a few seconds longer, because you know the great cost of this gift. Thank you very much.
All right, folks, before we get this party started, I got a couple little things I need to clarify. The graduates are going to enter up this side of the stage and collect a diploma here in front of the podium. And then we're going to have you exit down this ramp. That ramp, you can get an additional photo. And the parents, you guys can go as crazy as you want to when your kid's name is called, so rock out with that. The presentations of diplomas will now begin. Oh, one more thing. Graduates, you are free to take your mask off as you enter the stage. Mine will be off. If you want to take yours off, that's up to you. The presentation of diplomas will now begin. First row, please stand.
Emily Renee Fletcher. Matthew David Flynn. Valen Marie Foster. Dylan Zachary Fox. Garrett James Francine. Hannah Rose Carol Frank. Toby Lee Fries. Kendrick Christopher Fuller. Nadia Maria Hinojosa Gagnon. Leah Marie Gardner. Shelby Louise Gardner. Nathan Trent Gardner. Sydney Adele Gatton. Marissa Pearl Gifford. Gurneet Kaur Gill. Morgan Elizabeth Gilliam. Briley Jean Gillingham. Jackson Lee Goldsboro. Glenn Joseph Grabus III. Yeah. Raymond Patrick Graham. Austin Jacob Graves. Rayleigh Sarah Graves. Haley Emmeline Gray. Taryn Lee Greenhow. Terrence Lamond Greenhow Jr. Gregory William Griffith. Alexander Stephen Guy. Emily Lynn Guy. Hunter James Guy. Nathan Evan Guy.
Thank you.
Samantha Elizabeth Guy. Margaret Lillian Hall. Michael Walter Hardister. Andrew Hayes Harley. Nicholas Gordon Hara. Maya Nicole Harris.
I'm so proud of you.
Cassandra Lynn Hartman.
Are you before? After.
Stephen Collins Headley, the third.
Oh, no, I did that. Sorry. Thank you.
Jill Victoria Hayden. Samantha Jane Hyder. Caitlin Lorraine Herbert. Giselle Herrera Torres. Alexander Edward Hertzbach. Haley Marie Hewitt. Rebecca Pamela Hewitt. Abby Nicole Higgs. Jason Lane Hill. Jessica Megan Hill. Nicholas Michael Hill. Cheyenne Alicia Shello Hill. William Boyden Hill. Kelsey Nicole Holland. Alexis Nicole Holly. Cody James Holman. Christopher Matthew Holton, Jr. Douglas Allen Hoover, III. Layla Elizabeth Hauser. Trevor Joseph Howe. Dylan Matthew Huff. Ahmad Jaleel Hunt. Alexis Grace Hutchinson. Nash Dalton Hutchinson. Juliana Hudson. Elena Marie Jacobs. Jessie Nicole James. Dimitri William Jameson. Alexander Thomas Jacques. Piper Cheyenne Jeffries. Bailey Evan Johnson. Ian Michael Johnson. Caitlin Marie Johnson. Max Burton Johnson. Michael Lawrence Johnson, Jr. Michelle Patricia Johnson.
Thank you.
Tyreek Noah Johnson. Christopher Ross Karnbach. Alice Lilybeth Kelly.
Thank you.
Ashley Rose Kallenbach. Alexis Nicole Kemp.
Oh my gosh.
Destiny Marie Kearns.
Thank you.
Kayla Marie Kearns. Anthony James King. Dylan Christopher King. James Benjamin King. I got you. Jacob Austin Kirby. Brandon Lee Colby. Zoe Anna Marie Krauth. Marissa Elizabeth Cuno. Darren Michael Kurtz. Madeline Renee Ladd. James Richard Larimore III. Stephen Anthony Lawrence. Larry Joseph Laws. Wayne Allen Lehman Jr. Shelby Leanne Leonard. Helena Margaret Lair.
That was wonderful. We got one moment here while the graduates circle around that I want to do a couple little announcements here. So we're going to allow the graduates to stand and exit after another brief moment. We're going to ask the guests to stay while all the graduates leave, and then you can meet your graduates outside. Once you're outside, you'll have about 30 minutes, maybe a little more, where you can mingle in front of the school, take pictures, talk to the teachers, talk to your friends, meet with folks and do that sort of thing. So you have about 30 minutes out front of the building to do that, and you're welcome to take your mask off at that time. So, Dr. Smith, members of the Board of Education, by the virtue of the power vested in me, I'm pleased to certify the Chopticon High School class of 2021 as Maryland High School graduates. Graduates, please stand. Class of 2021, you may now move your tassel to the left. Congratulations.